when I first started working Landsat, you got film transparencies, so it wasn't digital data. It was digital here, but the world couldn't handle digital data, so the first thing we did when we downlinked the digital data was write it back to analog and distribute film.
Our data storage was tiny, and we couldn't process a lot of imagery, so we were kind of working on individual scenes. And we were also, you know, paying a lot of money per scene, and you had to have funding to support this.
A graduate student's career was often one Landsat image. They spent their whole career on that one Landsat image.
At our university, we had four or five images that we owned ourselves. If we had an image, we had to keep using that same image in our classes or for this purpose or that purpose over and over again.
The work was restricted to the data that an individual could afford rather than the imagery that were really needed to solve the problem. The methods, the approaches we used, and the size of the problems we were trying to solve were restricted in time, in space, and in complexity.
People both in NASA and the USGS, dating back to 1972 when the first satellite went up, really at that time felt that the data ought to be broadly and openly available.
The big push to make Landsat data free came from Barb Ryan. She began to realize the potential that it could have on impacting Landsat use around the world, and so she became the force to make that happen.
Obviously, the internet came into being, and so instead of sending out scenes on physical tapes, all of a sudden you could distribute data over the web.
Ever since that happened, to see the explosion in the use of Landsat has been amazing, especially the multi-temporal applications, the things that we can do with multi-temporal.
We've had this interesting convergence of analytical capabilities, computing capabilities, a better imagination, and of course, all surrounded by serious problems that need to be solved. I think we're poised to really start a more real-time focus on understanding the condition of the Earth.
We can now look at the world. Before, we said we could look at the world, but the reality was it was locked away in an archive, and we didn't have access to it. So I think that clearly is a huge change.
The policy for Landsat was a paradigm shift for the world. There's no doubt about it.
I think Landsat's healthier now as a program than it's ever been, and that is because it's so widely used.
You know, the archive is just going to continue to yield good information, good science, better management, reduce costs. The biggest contribution of Landsat will be that archive.